action.
When in your career did you start painting peacocks?
Painting peacocks! Peafowl.
Peafowl.
Okay. Peafowl, because the girls get left out. Let's see. Well, my first tattoo is a peacock.
Okay.
I got that when I was maybe 19.
So the stage was set at that point that your career was going to encompass peacocks.
Yeah, it's right back here. I'd show it to you, but it's, you know, back there. I love peacocks because I love Art Nouveau. Art Nouveau is my favorite of all time of art movements, and they really embraced the peacock because they were all about organic swirly lines and all that stuff, and the peacock was like the icon of Art Nouveau. So that's why I always liked the peacocks.
Okay.
And started with the tattoo, and then I started painting them, and then I started collaging them, and then I got really known for them.
Yes, you did.
I think one of my most successful original pieces was actually a peacock. And I've done lots of them. I've created lots of peacock collages.
Well, and the fact that when you Google her, what comes back oftentimes is a whole bunch of peacocks. We felt like, with all of the rice papers that we've done up until now, how did we miss peacocks?
How did we not do peacocks?
So we have remedied that. We have 6 rice papers, and Elizabeth will flip through them in the first part of her segment. She's going to show them to you one at a time. But what we have instead also is to show you some of what we did with them. So I'm going to let you go first.
I made a very cute, we shouldn't say cute. My high school art teacher said never use the word cute with regards to art. So let's rewind that, take it back. This very creative one, I started with a piece of rice paper, mounted it to the board, did some embellishing, and now I have a 6x8 piece of art that could be hung on the wall.
Yep, and you're actually going to see her create a second one in the video, so she's got 2 that she could hang together.
Same size, same orientation, yep. Horizontal.
It works perfectly. I took some of the rice papers in 2 cases. I use, so the sheets are set up, except for the 2 horizontal ones where you get 2 pieces per sheet. The others are set up where you're going to get 2 large, which is what you see here, and then there'll be some smaller ones. So I worked with a couple of large ones. This one is not embellished. This one, you can see that there's some foil on there and stickles. And then I worked with 2 of the smaller ones, and I continue to be on this framing kick. I really like the way that that looks. I like the sense of completeness that it gives, because I like framed things. I don't like edges that run on into nothing. The peahen, I think she gets the short end of the stick, and so I went ahead and I gave her some stickles and a little bit of foil too, because even the girls need a little bit of fun.
Of course.
Absolutely. And this one is my absolute favorite.
It's
the colors.
The foil really
yeah, it makes it look pretty awesome,
bumps it up a notch, really looks nice.
Yeah, so this set includes 6, and I think we get to work with perhaps all but one of them, so you're going to see a representation of how ways that you can use them.
Yeah, yeah. So
you want to go do it?
Yeah, let's
all
go.
Right,
show them.
Let's go do it.
So I'm super excited about yet another release of fantastic rice papers printed in Italy with joggles. And this set is peacocks. So I've got, I don't know how many sheets. How many are there, Barb?
There are 6.
There are 6. I don't even need to count them anymore. So there are 6 sheets, and these rice papers are A4 30 GSM paper. They've got some fibers in them, and they are really a nice weight for gluing down. They glue down really flat and really smooth without wrinkling because the rice paper is so absorbent. And the colors are really vibrant. I mean, these are reproductions of my artwork, and I am so happy with the color, the vibrant color on these rice papers. And the color is also UV fade resistant. And so all good things, right?
Absolutely.
So here's the first one. This is Jamie's peacock, and that's a 2-up on 1 sheet. The next one is Poised Peacock, and that's another horizontal 2-up on 1 sheet. The next one is Permission, and this one is a square format, so you've got 1 large one and 2 small ones. And that's on a nice cloudy sky blue background. This one is the female. This one is called Poignant, And it's another with a large and two smaller. I love the female peacock. I mean, you know, she doesn't get all the attention of the male peacock, but she sure is kind of pretty on her own. Don't you think?
I do, but I gotta tell you that when I do my part, I'm gonna give her a little bit of bling because I feel bad for her.
She deserves it.
She does.
So Barb's gonna give her some bling.
Yes.
And then the next one is called Praiseworthy, another one with a large format and two small. And then the last one is called Purple. This one is fun because it has some postage stamps on it.
And I'm going to play with those too when you see what I did with mine. So yeah, it works out really well.
Awesome. So that's the set. Okay. And the project that I'm working on, I'm so excited about this.
It's adorable.
Look at this. So it's on a cradled wood panel. So you can put a little wire on it or one of those claw hangers. The edges are finished. You can hang it up. And you've got a little kind of cool piece of artwork. And look at, I'm going to show you how to do that glitter and some Posca pen detail and that black vignette edge. So while we were messing with these, we are working on, where are my boards?
Right here. Here's
we go.
Your board, baby.
Sorry. I'm working on a wood panel, the 6x8 art alternatives, okay? And this is, like I said, it's cradled, so you finish the edges and you put your wire on the inside. It sets flat against the wall. This is the perfect size for this project. However, the black vignette edge, which I think makes the whole thing, was out of a creative solution for the fact that the large peacock leaves or left a slight edge of blank space on the board. So I was like, well, how can I finish that off? And at first I thought, well, I just put a band of color. But then I thought that this vignette really was the way to go.
And it was. It's so nice that way.
Yeah, I really like it. You could do it with any color. You could pick a different color from the front, like maybe a dark blue or a green or something. But, you know, Barb and I both agree that black adds drama.
Yes, so we are the drama queens.
The drama queens. Plus black, it's a neutral, so you don't have to worry about picking up any color from the front. So it should be addressed that these panels are raw wood. They're not primed and they're not sealed. So you do need to seal them before you glue the rice paper to them to avoid support-induced discoloration. Wood is acidic and it will leach yellow into your artwork eventually if you don't seal it. So what we've done here is we've sealed it with liquid acrylic medium, and then gesso. So I've got white gesso underneath the bird and the sealed board. So and the white underneath here also allows the bird to be real, the colors to stay vibrant and bright because the papers are slightly translucent. Because of the 30 GSM, they're slightly translucent. So if you put them over a dark color, you're gonna dull the colors on the front. So you wanna put them over white. Don't paint your whole board black first, otherwise you won't be happy with the vibrancy of this color. All right, so I'm gonna paint the edges black last, I think, or close to last, so that I don't drag my hand through the black. So the first thing that I did was I added the glitter gel, but then I learned I don't wanna drag my hand through the glitter gel either. So the first thing I'm gonna do is the Posca pens. But I also have to tell you that when I glued this to the board with gel medium, and then I put a full coat of gel medium on the top of the rice paper, that allows the Posca pens to really sit up on top of the paper. If you don't put a little gel medium over the whole surface, the pens tend to soak into the rice paper because it's so absorbent and they're not quite as bright. So I've got a few colors of Poscas, and the tip is the PC1M. It's the one that looks like this, but you could use, variety of different tips, whatever you're comfortable with. I like this one for this size for the detail. And when I'm doing that, I'm just adding, you know, a little blue to the blue areas, and sort of lightening them up. And just sort of, you know, making some accent marks. I'm not outlining everything, but I'm making some accent marks and bringing some bright color in here. Add a little of these feather edges and on the circles. Then I also did some, I have I think it's called coral pink. And I brought that in here around the edges of this. So you just do some doodling with your Posca pens, whatever colors you have. The bright green is definitely a good one. And I do some crosshatch marks in the dark areas with this. That gives it, you know, you want to use contrast. The green really stands up over colors that are darker. And I can just kind of add some of these sort of peacock feathery shapes. And then this one is the perfect color for it. This is...
I think that one's aqua green. It's one of the new colors in that tip size.
Yeah, aqua green. Yeah, you got to have like x-ray vision to read anything on these products.
Yes, you do.
It's all small. So the aqua green, that's definitely one that I like in here. And then in the back of the tail, I like to accent some of these tail feathers. The green works well, but it blends in a little bit. So I actually came in here with the light blue. You know, you just doodle around and do whatever you want to add some fun to it, okay? And, oh, I do like this too. This is the fuchsia because I have red in here, which, you know, doesn't occur in a peacock, but I just love it. So I definitely like bringing a little bit more red in there with the fuchsia pen because it's picking up the red that I already painted in there. So I like bringing a little bit of that in there too. Okay. All right, don't get carried away, Elizabeth. All right, so now the next thing I'm gonna do is I think I'll paint the edges and then I'll add the glittery glue stickles. So I've got Stickles Glitter Gel in the pots. This one is Aquarius, this one is Galaxy. So we've got one that's like a real true blue and one that's an aqua blue. And then I've got a fun one in the squeeze top. This is Glam Pink, okay? So I'm just gonna take some black acrylic, put it out here on my nonstick craft mat. And I paint all the edges, all the sides, and then the front. And I won't make you painstakingly watch me paint the sides. So for the front, I'm using heavy body acrylic, so it has some dry time, you know, that we can manipulate it. So I'm gonna bring it in around the edges, sort of feathered, and I'm just gonna work quickly. I'm not worried about, you know, getting it exact. I'm just bringing it in, and what this is doing is covering that edge that didn't get filled with the rice paper, and it's also just giving it that dramatic border. So you just wanna kinda come in from the edge with the black. Make sure you get full coverage because that white gesso is gonna really show if you miss a spot. And the thinness of this rice paper, you don't even see a ridge in there when you go over with the black. Also, black's a great color for that because it absorbs the light. So you're definitely not gonna see the ridge where the rice paper ends. Okay, so now I've got that. And I've got like a wet paper towel here. You could probably also use a baby wipe. And now I'm just gonna kind of rub it, give it a little softness with a little rub. And remember, I coated this rice paper with gel medium. So I've got a surface on it that's gonna allow me to do this. Rubbing it with water without that gel medium on the top, you know, might be a little difficult with this rice paper. So another good reason for that. There's fan brushes you could use to make a really soft edge. You could rub it with your fingers. I mean, you know, whatever you're comfortable with. Or putting more of it on in the place where you don't want it. There.
Well, that's the beauty of the gel medium. It does give you a little bit of latitude to pick it up.
Yeah, yeah. It's definitely not soaking into the surface of the rice paper with the gel medium on top. But you can't fuss around for too long because you'll get down here and it'll be dry. I think that looks pretty good.
I think it looks great.
Okay. So now this is going to be wet for a little bit. So what I want to show you here is that I came back in with the pen, with the Posca, and I pulled a few lines out over the black vignette edge. That way it kind of incorporates it in and out, right? So I just did a few more doodles once the black was dry with my Posca and pulled a few lines out the edges of the black, okay? So now I'm gonna use the glitter gel, and for the pots, I love these because in the pots they have big chunky shapes There's like little stars and chunks, and there's stars in here. And then in this one, they've got like circular shapes. So I love these. I do. I like the squeeze top one as well because you have real control with this where you want to put it. And I'm going to show you how I use that. But these chunks in here just make my heart happy. So I'm just going to take a little bit of it with the palette knife. And I'm just going to sort of put the teal color on the collage part of the bird that is that color. You know, in the teal area, which is sort of in the breast here. And then a little bit in the feathery tops here. And it doesn't need to be precise at all. The art is precise. And this is just an accent. So you don't need to feel as though you have to get it in exactly the right place or that there's any specific amount. You know, it's all good. So we'll add that to the top of his head like that. And then with the darker color, I'm gonna put that in the more blue areas, but not the super dark blue area under here, but in the area where it's already sort of that value, so I don't make it light in the dark area. So I'm just putting it right there on the blue. Look at that, Barb. That looks awesome.
It's sparkly. I love it.
And a little down here. And, oh, I'm pulling that over the edge of the black, and it's not smearing, so that's kind of okay. So there we go. I pull a little bit across the bottom. Oh, that looks nice, doesn't it?
Yeah, well, it really extends the image to the edge, even though the actual rice paper doesn't go that far.
Yeah, and I like how we intercept the black a little bit, or intersect, that's what I'm trying to say. God, I can't talk. You know, so some, like the Posca marks come out and some of this comes out. So I'm gonna grab a little bit of this previous color and bring the head piece out a little bit too, okay? So, and then, like I said, I would come in and pull some more lines out with the pen. Let's see, it's dry right there. So, you know, I just, not all of them, but just some of them, I'm gonna bring back out like that. And then you get just a neat kind of effect with it integrated with the edges. All right, so I will finish this and I'll sign it and I'll have two that I can hang together. Oh. The pink gel. I was going to show you that.
Oh, good grief. Let's not miss the pink.
Yeah, the pink. So on this, I'm going right around these feather eyes in the middle. I love that with the little pink. We can bring that one out here. So this is nice because it's very accurate application. I can put it right around the edge of the feather eyes and give myself a little accent. I think that's it.
I think you're right. Yeah. As much as we want to continue with the pink.
Yeah, well, this one has a lot more. So for fans of pink, this one has a lot more on it, you know, because there's more feather eyes. And look at that glittery goodness.
I know. It just is marvelous.
And then this one. So now you can hang these as a pair or give them as a gift or whatever. Put them like this. There.
Yeah, they look great together.
Thanks.
When I played with the new peacock rice papers, first of all, I was just enamored with all of them because they all come from Elizabeth's paintings. But this one, which is named Permission, is my absolute favorite, probably because it is so strongly turquoise, teal, and those wonderful jade colors. And that happens to be right in my wheelhouse. But I also used, because I love this acidy green, I also used this one named Praiseworthy. And then, because who doesn't love purple? You know, I'm always going to be a 12-year-old girl who loves purple. So I used this one that is appropriately named Purple. And here's what I did. Oops. Since I was working on rice papers recently, I've been on this framing kick. So this is our 6x6 watercolor cardstock. This is a 6x6. I happen to use gray because with the peahen, she is on gray, her background is, and she tends to be a little bit more muted. But again, as I said earlier, I think the peahens get the short end of the stick. So I gave her some stickles here And I have no idea what I did with them. It doesn't matter. And I used, so this is denim iCraft Deco Foil. So I feel like the peahen gets the short end of the stick. So I just went and I gussied her up a little bit. So this is 6x6 and I cut this out and I left myself a 1-inch border. This is the small version of the size on the A4 rice paper. This too is the small version, but here, because I wanted to squeeze this a little bit and have more framing, this is actually 1.25 inches wide. And you can see how big a difference that makes. It's only 1/4 inch all the way around, but obviously it's more frame here. Now I haven't done anything. I think I'm probably going to. This happens to be the large version from whichever the ones this the name is, I don't remember. But I was kind of had a dilemma. I had this big area that I wanted to cover, but this wasn't tall enough. So I took, this is one of our number 12 tags, and I sprayed some color on here that was similar to the background. I adhered the rice paper to it, and now I had an area that was big enough to cover what I wanted to do and still leave kind of this frame around the edge. This one doesn't have any stickles or deco foil on it, but it's still beautiful the way that it is. And then this last one, which is the purple, or from the sheet named purple, and I can turn that to you.
Look at that.
I know, foil, some, there's stickles on here too. What you can't see, you know, let me bring this in. In here, Elizabeth, as part of her original painting, had some stamps on there, and I thought, well, okay. Now, I will admit that I cherry-picked through stamps, and you may not, thank you very much.
You're
you
welcome.
May not always have purple stamps, but really, that doesn't make any difference. But I just covered these up with stamps, so they're on there. And again, stickles and the foil. And if I'd had, we always have limited supplies when we're working together, because neither of us are at home in our studio. What I would have done if I'd had enough was something bigger, and I would have framed this, because I really, really do like the way you get the effect that you get when you frame these. So yeah, I'm real happy with them, and these are going to land on journal pages someplace, or I'll figure out something incredibly creative to do with them.
So now that we've got ourselves aligned in the frame.
Well, we spent a half an hour straightening ourselves up with the camera.
Yeah.
But anyway, even though this was all about rice papers, peacocks are also all about sparkly glittery. So it was fun to add the foil and the stickles glitter gel.
Yeah.
So
we had
anyway,
fun. We hope
yeah,
you do too.
We hope you enjoy being
yeah.
creative with them. Tag us on social media.
Yes.
We'd like to see what you're doing with this stuff.
Absolutely.
All right.
Bye.
Bye.